Thank you for listening to The Mentor Project, where we discuss marketing, SEO, how to go full-time in your business, and so much more. Here's your host, Nicole Bruce.
Hey guys, the last few episodes have been epic, loaded with information, exciting, personable, and some of them a little bit long. But today I'm going to try and attempt to make the subject of marketing exciting so that you don't fall asleep. We're taking a step back to talk about something that not many talk about or even recognize in the industry, but it will make or break your business. ROI. This is actually one of my favorite parts of having a business because it's thrilling and sometimes disappointing, but either way, it can always help your business progress. This is one of those episodes that will be loaded with useful information, but probably not the most exciting episode ever. But it can make sure your business is in the right place. So let's talk about ROI. ROI means return on investment. First, you have your marketing plan, which you're going to design to choose the best marketing strategies for yourself. But next, you have to measure those methods as they're taking action. This may be for Google, Instagram, Facebook, whatever marketing you're using that is being paid for. You don't want to keep the ones that don't work. If they don't work, you don't make money, right? If you have paid marketing, which is necessary to really grow your business and let it take off quickly, unless you just intend on letting it grow slowly or stay really, really small, then you need to know how much your company is making per month and what portion of that is related to your paid marketing. This is where ROI comes in. Every month, you should be tracking how much your marketing is bringing into your company versus how much you're paying for it. This will determine your ROI. If you're making under what you're spending, then obviously it isn't worth it. For example, let's say you're spending $200 a month on Google, but it's only making you $150 a month. That stream is not reliable or making profit, as it's not even making over what you're spending, so you should probably let that stream go. But let's look into it a little bit further with a little more complicated situations. Now, if you see that stream in the future keep growing and keep progressing, maybe it only made $25 the month before, but now it's making $150 a month, then you can keep that stream and let it grow. If it only made $25 the month before and then it makes $150 the next month, it's growing pretty quickly and you should probably keep on that marketing stream. If there's a history with the marketing stream that is constantly under what you're spending, drop that marketing stream altogether. It's making you negative. Negative ROI streams can destroy your business as you're gathering too many expenses for the company with not enough income to make up for it. Expenses are great, especially for taxes, but you don't want them to be over your income. Otherwise, your business is negative and on the path to bankruptcy. Now, if you just started your business and you're in the first 2 years, you are allowed to be negative as the IRS sees it as you're investing in your startup. However, in my growing of my companies, which is photography related, of course, I have never been negative even in startup. But again, I'm also not running a construction business, which has a butt ton of investment needed to start up. One issue I see quite a bit with photographers is just having too many expenses. We get wrapped up in what's new and what's great, and we just need it all. A lot of businesses go negative in the first few years, like I said before, and that's okay. But photography, I honestly have no idea how. You don't need much investment to take pictures. If you have a studio, that's obviously a little bit different. If you're just a wedding photographer, you may need two cameras, 2 to 4 flashes, a few lenses, and some memory cards. It should add up to maybe $10,000 or $15,000, and you should be making that back in about 5 to 10 weddings. If you need more equipment, grow with your company. You don't need to start out with all of this equipment. A lot of the time, if you buy a lot of equipment before you start, you probably won't end up using it all. The baseline, expenses help on taxes, but you never want to be over your tax line on expenses. If taxes are 30% of what you're making, your expenses should be 2%. You should always have a profit quite a bit over your expense line. It's okay to pay a few taxes. If you do need help tracking your income versus your expenses and your tax lines, I recommend an accountant because they can really help you stay on track and in the green. But anyways, I can rant on taxes all day long, but let's get back to the ROI. Let's say you have a stream that is bringing in income consistently. You spend $300 and it gives you $3,000. Let's call this stream A. But let's say you have another stream that you spend $300 and it gives you $30,000. And yes, this is totally possible. We'll call this stream B. At this point, they're both earning, but the second is earning much more. This is where looking at past records of the streams come in handy. Is stream A worth keeping? Is it consistently over what you're spending? Or does it duck down and go negative sometimes? B is clearly making way more of a return than source A, but if source A is bringing in income too and it's consistent, then I would keep both of them. Why not keep something that's pulling in income, even if it's just a little bit? I always prefer to eliminate all unstable sources and keep what I know will be growing for me. For example, I use the Knot, and right now it's not pulling as much as it usually does. But I have older streams in other geographic areas that are pulling a crazy ROI, so I'm going to let my little streams in my newer geographic areas grow, even if it's barely clearing ROI right now. Why? I have a history that it works, but it needs time to grow. Either way, you should be tracking your sources of marketing versus the income they pull every month. If it's not pulling any income, eliminate that expense. You know your expenses, we got that down. But how do you find out what each marketing stream is making? Google, Facebook, Instagram. How the heck do you know where your bookings are coming from? The easiest way is your website contact form. It can be something as simple as, "Where did you hear about us?" with a short answer form for them to input the source they heard about you from. Then I use a software called Streak, which is free with Gmail. It integrates with Gmail to help you track leads. And it also does follow-ups, which is amazing. Did I mention this is free? With this software, you can input where leads are coming from, which then makes a chart for me to show what each stream is pulling. The nerdy side of me screams with excitement when I find such useful software. The Streak system also tracks dates, so you can know when the lead came in. Furthermore, you can add your own columns. You can track what date each booking comes in and is actually booked on, and even how much each sale was. So when do I do all of this? Because this is actually kind of a lot, and it probably sounds like it, but it only takes a few minutes. I do this after the first of every month. I set up a chart in Excel or Google Spreadsheets that I can write down how much each stream is making per month. I also write down how much I'm making per month in net, which means not including any processing fees or sales tax, etc. I set a goal for myself and I track it every month to make sure that I'm hitting it. I then calculate sales tax in a different chart. And in a different chart, my revenue streams are my marketing streams. I make sure my marketing streams are staying consistent, and I eliminate any subscriptions or paid advertising that just is not working for us. That way, I have a record every single month that shows what's working, what may not be working, and then I can take action and make sure my business is not wasting money on marketing. I know you're thinking that, hey, if I'm only spending about $50 on marketing a month right now, this probably doesn't matter that much. But once you get your business going, marketing can be really expensive, so it's important. For example, a few months ago, I was paying $500 a month for one marketing stream where I made maybe $50 over profit on that stream per month. Once I saw that, I cut that marketing out and switched to something else that is hopefully working much better now. I have to track it today since the month just ended, so let's keep our fingers crossed. So once you start your business, obviously you probably won't be throwing down $500 a month for marketing, but once your business gets going, you will be. So since I cut out that $500 a month that clearly was not working for us, I saved $500 a month, or 500 times 12, which is quite a bit of money every single year. Business is all about making over what you're spending. I know this episode wasn't super fun or woohoo, but hopefully it did help get your mind in the right place to grow a crazy successful business and to grow with your business. In closing, keep in mind that your marketing plan is always going to change. If something doesn't work, it just doesn't work. Some media like social media, Instagram, Facebook, it might fall off over time. So be prepared to always check those numbers and make sure that you're in the green. Until next time. Thank you for listening to The Mentor Project with Nicole Bruce. Tune in next time for more on marketing, SEO, and going full-time as a creative.